I'm gonna tell you 6 things you should not do when you're pre-approved and in the process of buying your new home. Let's do this. My name is John and I am a mortgage broker located in Canada, and welcome to another video. If this is your first time here and you wanna learn ways to be approved for a mortgage, home buying tips, and other mortgage related stuff, start now by subscribing and clicking the notification button so you won't miss anything. If you're looking to purchase a new home, regardless of whether you have a pre-approval in place, ensure you do not do the following, as it will prevent you from getting approved for a mortgage. Number one, do not change jobs, become self-employed, or quit your job. Income is a very important factor in determining how much you can borrow. If you do have a change in your job status, banks and lenders may or may not allow the income to be used for qualification. Number two, do not buy any high-ticket items that require financing. Whenever you purchase a big-ticket item, it's often either leased or financed. The monthly payments will be added to your debt servicing calculation, resulting in a lower qualified mortgage amount. Things to avoid include things like a new car, appliances, furniture, and so on. Number three, do not use your credit cards excessively or let your debt payments fall behind. Having excessive debts and late payments will tarnish your credit score. If your credit score falls below 680, the amount of money you can borrow drastically decreases. Ensure you pay your bills on time and maintain your credit score. Number four, do not spend money you have set aside for closing costs. There are closing costs involved, such as legal fees, GST, and property transfer tax. Ensure you have at least 1.5 to 2% of the purchase price in your bank account allocated for closing costs. Closing costs cannot be borrowed. If you don't have enough on completion date, the transaction will not go through even though your mortgage is fully approved. Number five, do not make large deposits into your bank account without letting your mortgage broker know. Canada is really cracking down on anti-money laundering. Banks are required to question all large deposits and how you obtain it within a period of 90 days. Unless there's a valid reason for the deposit, it's best to avoid any unnecessary barriers for getting a mortgage application approved. Number six, don't co-sign a loan or mortgage for anyone. Even though you're co-signing for someone else to get the loan, it still shows up as a loan under your name on the credit bureau. Since you're responsible if the loan defaults, the monthly payment for the loan will still be added toward the debt servicing calculations, resulting in a lower approved amount. In addition, if there are any late payments on the loan, even though it's not your fault, it will also affect negatively on your credit report. And there you go. 6 things you should not do when you're pre-approved and in the process of buying your new home. Feel free to contact me if you have any questions. And lastly, please remember to subscribe to my YouTube channel to learn more, and make sure you click on the notification button so you won't miss a video. I'm John Lee, mortgage broker and CEO of Arise Mortgage. We are always achieving your approval.